it's your girl, legendary MsTee, and we having a hot discussion about being a side hoe. Don't forget to tune into my video. You ain't nothing but a side hoe. A side hoe. I got my girl, Madam Ashley. I got my cousin, Vern. And I got the hairstylist, Shonia. We gonna get up in here and talk about the real talk about why you should be a side hoe, why you shouldn't be a side hoe. We gonna talk about having threesomes and all that today. You heard? And we want y'all opinions. So comment down below. You heard me? On Legendary MsTee YouTube. You heard me? Let's go. Side hoe. What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Legendary MsTee, and we're here today to have a discussion on the side hoe. Y'all know I have that song, Side Hoe. I just released a video on YouTube. You heard me. It's did by my boy, produced by Chris Henry. Y'all got to get on that thing. Well, today I got my girl, Vern. Introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Bernice. I'm the sixth wall. This is my cousin, and you know. Double platinum, baby.
I got my girl Ashley.
Hey, it's the madam. This my sis, my best friend, my BFF.
Ooh, that was a good one. Yeah. And we got my girl Shawnee, the hairstylist.
Shawnee, I am her cousin. That is my BFF. We have these talks on a regular.
So oh, yeah.
Collectively have these talks on a regular, so we're not just attacking side holes. We just got a goal in common.
Oh, yeah.
Discuss you, bitch.
Well, you know, me personally, I have never been a side hole.
Really?
Yes. You know, in the beginning, young, you know, my nose was so in the clouds that being a side hoe wouldn't have been beneficial. It wouldn't have been official, and I couldn't have met a man to do what I wanted him to do, what I needed him to do for me, you know, that I need this and I need that, and be a side hoe.
And basically, that's why I wrote the song, because I wanted girls to know that, you know, being a side hoe, that ain't what's up. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because I see a lot of girls with low self-esteem. It's just like, look, I'm going to be the side, you know, whatever.
Boy, cousin, I'm not in defense by no means necessary for side hoes. But what I can say is, sometimes you might be in a situation where you meet somebody, y'all vibing, y'all chilling, and me might be on a break from her.
Right, that's true.
They may be at odds, and you might have an impeccable vibe.
Personally, I don't think there's anything such as a side hoe, personally.
Why?
I feel as though there's
girlfriend number two.
No such thing. I just feel as though there's a man that's disrespectful, that's greedy, and it's just in a relationship with two people. That's how I feel.
Cousin. I'm gonna call you cousin. You've been around her long enough. The family round table. Now, I am gonna say there are some girls, okay? Now, that's why I said I'm not for those girls, and I do call them side hoes. There are some women that will see your man take care of you. He's taking you on trips, and he's buying you nice things, and he got you dripped up and draped out. Right. And she might see you being a hustler, and we hustlers. Like, so we don't know what it feels like not to be a hustler. So some women see you at a certain point or a certain, you know, height in your career, and they feel like, man, maybe he helped her get there. I want that nigga.
I require you a lot, but here's the thing. Why you can't have your own man to require that? Why you gotta have somebody else fucking nigga to require that? Like,
that's a very good question.
For real, like, why you can't have your own man and you gotta fuck with somebody else, man? And I also think that sometimes women like the competition part too. Like,
You're right.
He gonna do, like, even if you look at Love and Hip Hop, we look at the Mimi situation with Jocelyn. Jocelyn came in that bitch aggressive and was like, look, you gonna do this, you gonna do that.
Those his wife comes
today, the man today is different from what they was designed to be. They already putting baby mommy in the equation.
Wait, break that down. Wait, break that down.
Like, it's okay to have a baby mama. Mm-hmm. Like, that's what you do. When you grow up and you a man, you supposed to already have purpose in life and on your way to have purpose. That's why that's the difference from somebody, a grown man, and then a little boy who's in a relationship and gonna have a person on the side.
Condone this. I'm gonna keep saying this throughout our conversation. Woo! Condone it. I'm not for it. I but what I'm saying is, like, some women, if they want your nigga, they gonna do what it takes to get your nigga. Comes to a relationship all together, like, if you meet a man and he sees your work and he knows what he has, like, even if he falls short, I'm gonna say, like, you have to, and that's my personal experience, like, you have to teach people how to deal with you.
Right.
Like, if I'm in a relationship with you and I know exactly what it is that I bring to the table and I know what it is that I provide, I'm not going to allow you to make me feel like I'm less than, and I'm not gonna let you make me fall short when it comes to a side bitch. So me as a woman, I know what I take and what I'm not gonna take. But you have some women that will step into the equation knowing that they see me as an alpha female and I have a strong omega male. Like, those bitches,
you're not a strong omega male. If he,
they can be strong. It's not about that. You wanna talk Bible, like, even in the Garden of Motherfucking Eden, Adam was with Eve, and then you had. I'm gonna talk that shit, cause I'm gonna go back to your first love story with a side, whatever. Like, Eve was a little.
Yeah.
But you know, like, whenever there's ever a situation and someone is ever included, like, you have people that are on the outside that's looking to get what you have.
Right. But that's the, I understand what you're saying.
He's a man. Like, so at the end of the day, you can, like, do roundhouse kicks on the dick. You can do whatever it is to make your man stay at home. You can cook, clean, wash, do everything. Like, you can be in the
kitchen.
That's what I'm saying. But you have to also understand, like, there are several different types of men.
A man is a man, period. It's different. Listen, let her talk. It's different personalities and different things that people can do. But if a man is a man, period. And let's go back to the Bible, because you brought it up. Listen, the man was created first. It was God's best creation that he ever made.
We were created for them.
But listen, but we were different.
I didn't even deal with them.
Listen, he was created first, meaning that he's the head. We are the followers. We ought to be submissive. We are the tail. Independent. I'm not gonna say I don't need a man. I'm gonna say it like this here. I know what God intended for a man to be. He intended him to be the head and me to be submissive. People forget their roles. That's the whole problem.
To each his own.
That's what I said. I don't agree with that.
I don't believe in that.
We don't do that.
I feel that as a teammate, we both compromise,
right,
give and take on each other.
Absolutely.
So sometimes he submits.
I'm with it.
Right. You feel me? And sometimes I submit. So it's not like always let's lean towards a female and he be the head.
But that's how you get bad.
Because sometimes I'm the head. You
right,
feel
right,
me?
Right. But
I'm the finance.
Right.
He can't tell me nothing about money. Nothing about money. But he makes more money. You feel me?
That's right.
All his money has to come to me because the strong part that when it comes to
working.
Let's go to my cuz Burn. Do you think the side hoes winning? They always say it. They say Kim Kardashian winning.
Mm.
They say Black China winning, how she played Rob and all that. Like, they look at those girls like side hoes, Amber Rose and shit like that. But I like Kim Kardashian. Yeah. I think she's I like her because she's a business woman.
So do you think the side hoes winning? I don't really think the side hoes winning because they still gonna have to cover some type of like life expense, you know, with their own selves.
Explain the life expense.
Due to that, you a side hoe, that means that this man is going home to his main woman.
Right.
You feel me? So if he's leaving, that means his majority of his life expenses are with where he's going. Okay? So yeah, he throw you a little money. Yeah, he do that for you. But like, you still gotta kinda cover yourself that he's absent.
Mm-hmm.
When it's time for like actual life,
mm-hmm.
You know, when it's if you have a child and this lady have a child, what child is he gonna make sure he's obligated to? The child with his main woman, you know. If you have
I always thought about that, like when he died, everything go to
the main
wife.
Woman. Yeah, so like the side hoe kind of get like you get what's convenient.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like I can work, I can do this. I can do this, and when it's convenient, you know, here you go. You know what I'm saying?
So you don't think they winning?
I don't really think they winning, because if a man like has to pay his child tuition and take care of his side hoe, I mean, as a man, I'm paying a tuition.
For you, he always leave you miserable. So pitiful, confused, he playing with you. You want competition, on you say what his woman don't do. But baby girl, he would never really be with you. He don't ever see a future with you. But the late night, great sex, he creeping with you. He give you a secret. We all know he really creeping. Cause if he ain't really happy, he will leave you just an extra. You ain't what you want.